if you've ever been married or had people close to you who have been married, then you would agree with me that marriage is not easy. It is not easy to maintain. It is not easy to keep it. But is it possible? Is it possible to sustain and keep a marriage going? In today's video, I want to share with you my thoughts on three things. Three things that will make your wife leave for good. Three things. If you want your wife to leave you, just do these three things. Or if you want her to remain with you for life, make sure you take care of these three areas. Stay tuned. I'll be right back. Welcome back. This is Angie Marie and this is my YouTube channel where we talk about the simple secrets of life, life issues, the things that will help to keep us joyful, happy, peaceful, at peace, things such as great relationships, good travel, vacations, money, finance, family, the main things that would keep us going and keep us happy. And today I want to delve into this issue of, well, this is really my belief on what is it that will sustain a great marriage, that will keep it going for good permanently, where we don't have to be part of the divorce statistics. And I have been in marriage before, I've been divorced before, so I'm speaking to you from experience. And I've also counseled and helped a lot of people who have been in situations where the marriage was not working, the marriage was failing. And so in sharing today, I'm coming to you with experience. We've been living in an era of ongoing miscommunication and misunderstanding between men and women. And the truth is, that's not anything that's new. Divorce, high rates of divorce, that's been going on for quite for a long time. I did make a promise that I'd do a video that expresses the three main things that women want in a marriage, in a relationship. And sometimes a woman might be timid, or she may not want to say some of these things to you because she does not want to hurt your feelings. She does not want to make you feel bad. She doesn't want to hurt your ego, so she may not tell you. But in today's video, I'm going to try to break things down and share with you exactly some of the three things that I believe the woman really needs. And sometimes the marriage, the relationship breaks down because these three ingredients are missing. If this is the first time you're checking out my channel, you're so welcome. I'm happy to have you. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button, like this video, and you can share it if you like. Share your own thoughts. Maybe you're from a different culture, from a different religious belief, and I welcome your thoughts on this. If this is your first time visiting, checking out my channel, you're so welcome. My name is Angie Marie, and I love to engage with you, so please feel free. YouTube is still fairly new for me. I am more on Facebook, where I relate a lot there, but I'm working on expanding and on YouTube as well. It brings me so much joy if this were to happen. So that's my biggest thing that I ask of you. To engage with me, share your comments, like this video, go ahead and subscribe if you have not yet done so. If this is your first time visiting my channel, you're so welcome. And if you're a returning subscriber, you are the best part of this channel, and I'm just happy to have you. All right, so let's delve straight into the topic at hand. And I'm gonna just tell you honestly from my heart and how I see it. If you're in a marriage right now and struggling and really want the marriage to work but struggling, my prayers are with you, and there is help out there. I tell people all the time, do not suffer in silence. Do not throw away your marriage, because I believe that marriage is a beautiful thing when you've found the right person, and if both of you can understand each other, work on your marriage and try to resolve issues. It's amazing, it's interesting how certain things such as a person's culture impact on our reality. I may not be speaking about the entire world of marriage, so I'm sharing with you from my understanding and knowledge and experience as a woman. I am sharing with you based on my principles, my belief, and part of that is based on biblical principles, what I know. So there are some things that would impact on my perspective and my view. Whatever I'm going to share with you would be influenced by culture to an extent. In breaking down what are the three things that a woman really needs. I want to put in some disclaimers because, of course, you may have the 0.1%, 0.001%, or maybe even 4% of women who may be a little different. And so I cannot say that, even though I'm a woman and have been a woman all my life, I cannot say that I can speak for all women and all cultures. But I do believe that I'm speaking for more than 90%, possibly 95% of women, regardless of their culture, because basically a woman is a woman created a particular way, and we have needs, we have tendencies, we have hormones, and so forth. So I know I'm speaking for the majority. Let's start by focusing first on the main needs that a woman has. Number one, a woman needs to feel safe. A woman needs to feel safe if she's with a man, within a marriage, with a guy in a relationship. There is no woman who is happy to feel that she's not safe with this person. Can she trust him? Can she trust him to be her protector? Yes, I do believe that the man is made physically stronger than the woman. I believe where man and woman are not at the same level physically. Let's not go into the emotional aspect and so forth, but that's my basic belief. And I believe that in terms of the relationship dynamic between a man and a woman, the man is expected to be more of a protector. The woman wants to feel safe. The man naturally has the muscles, muscle tone and volume and so forth, and has the strength. So the woman wants to feel in general safe and protected by her man. She needs to feel safe and protected. I'm gonna start with a foundational principle that I believe. All right, listen to this carefully. Here is how I see the foundation or the start of a marriage. This is based on a biblical principle that talks about the kingdom of God. The Bible says that the kingdom of God is like treasure hidden in a field. When a man finds it, he immediately hides it. And then he goes out and sells everything he has and he buys that field. Now, I'm gonna show you the similarity in terms of what I believe about a woman and a man and a marriage, God's word and so on. Hey, you know, that's me. If you believe something different, that's okay too, but that's my belief. The man needs to find the woman, all right? So me personally, I'm old school. I don't go initiating or looking for no man. I believe I'm valuable. And the right one will see me and find me and will not be intimidated by me. He will come searching. And when he finds me, he will initially do this. It says, well, I see it that way. He will hide her. It's like he finds treasure. He recognizes that this is great treasure. And by hiding that treasure at first, how I view that is protecting it. He's not gonna put it out there so that the elements could destroy it before the foundation is literally set. And sometimes this is some of the things people do. People make these kinds of mistakes. If you find precious diamond, gold, silver, precious jewelry, you're gonna have to protect it because there are thieves out there. There are people out there who want to steal things, to steal valuables, and some who may want to destroy it. So at the beginning, you're gonna hide it and protect it while you're building that solid foundation. Finding a good woman is like treasure in a field. The man finds her, find it, then he immediately hides it at first to protect it, and then he goes and sells everything he has, and then after selling everything he has, he comes back and buys that field. Now, I know, you know, some of you are probably saying, hey, what is this? This is nonsense. Buying a woman, that's not what I'm trying to say. What I'm trying to say, well, the application for this is that the man who is wise, who is smart, who understands the value of a good woman will do those things. First, he will look for her. He will have his eyes open. And when he sees what he's looking for, he moves at it. He finds that treasure. He immediately protects it first, builds on it. Then he goes and sells everything he has. And he comes back and buys it. How I see selling everything he has is you realize that this one is valuable. So you're going to protect it and you're going to make sure you invest in this. Now, when I say invest and buying, I'm not necessarily talking about spending money, although money is also important. But I'm talking about your investment of your time, your energy, your focus, and even finances to have this valuable possession, because you're seeing the lot in the long run. You're not just short term, you're seeing long term. This is one of the things that I noticed with a lot of people. They can't see the possibilities 10 years, 20 years and later. Everything is about the now, microwave kind of thing. I want this now, everything must happen now, and they cannot see beyond today. A wise person who's looking for a good wife, looking for a woman for life, will think about the future, and therefore he's not going to be playing around with, let's say, costume jewelry and making this woman a side chick, a side meal, a side dish to whatever he had before. And I've been in situations where, you know, you meet someone and then they say they want you, they're serious, but then there are other relationships they had in the past who keep interrupting, disturbing. You guys are trying to eat together, trying to get to know each other or whatever, and then there's this constant interruption with phone calls or distractions from other people that they've been with in the past. And if they would have the nerve to tell you, well, I knew this one 20 or 30 or whatever years before you, then lady, that's number one. She's a wise, smart woman is not gonna stay with you. She may not argue and fight with you because of her personality or her temperament, but she's gonna say, no, this is not the one for me. And that's it. Because which woman wants that? No one wants that, okay? So the foundation, the man finds this precious gem, this jewel. He recognizes it as precious. This one is different. He does is that he protects it first, hides it, then he goes sell, get rid of all of that. If you're trying to build with a good wife, a good woman, you cannot do it by tugging along other baggage, excess baggage with you. It's gonna break it down, it's gonna tear everything down, and she's gonna leave. She's going to leave. She's not, especially a woman who has had experience like that before. She learned from her past experiences. If I say to herself, okay, this is what he wants, he's interested in these other women, she's out of it. For me personally, I've said this to a couple times to guys, I'm not gonna be a fruit in anybody's salad or a vegetable in anybody's salad, like just one piece of orange or a piece of pineapple in a salad. I do not belong in, nor do I believe in polygamy. God bless those of you who do. I've seen people, more mature women who have said, now they're in their 70s and they're saying they don't mind if the, as long as the guy tells them up front that this is it, you're just one of several, they don't mind. Well, one thing I know is that polygamy is illegal in the US, but we know, you know, certain things are practiced. But for me personally, I can't handle the stress. I've had enough of that in my past. I can't handle the stress of women and the manipulation and what women do, and they cripple your finances from the beneath, because money and so on is drained out of your family resources when a man gets involved with several of them, when you're also trying to build with the man and money is just flowing out with women. No, I'm not saying you can't have friends or friendships, although various different people have different views and beliefs on that. There's some women who will tell you, no, you can't have female friends. That's up to them. I'm not one of those who say, well, you can't talk to any females or no, but I believe there must be respect, and you have to value what you have to the extent that you respect her, you protect her from the elements, you protect her from danger. And several, having many women is dangerous to a good marriage and good relationships. So the man, he finds her and he immediately hides it while he's building the foundation. And while during that, he goes and sells what he has, and then he comes back and buys the entire field. And you notice it's not saying, I'm not talking about a bride price where you're paying for a wife. And I've learned about the culture, for instance, West African culture, where there's a bride price. And when I found out more about that, I admire that culture. I believe it's a good thing. As I grew in my understanding of how it works, I realized that it's not about paying for a woman. It's just showing your commitment. It's showing that you will support and provide for and take care of this woman, because we take care of the things that we're invested in. If a man will not invest in you in terms of his time, his energy, his focus, his attention, and otherwise, he's not a keeper, you're gonna have problems. It says he buys the field. Now the thing about that I see in that is that you're not just buying the jewel that you found there. The fact is, it's an entire field. So how I see that is that there's purpose involved. There is growth, there is expansion. It's two people are coming together with a purpose, and together you're gonna build and leave a legacy. You're gonna build together a financial dynasty, so that by the time you leave this earth, you're leaving something, you're leaving a legacy for your children, your grandchildren, and their children, and their children's children's children. And that is what is supposed to happen when two people who are wise come together where the man leads. All right, so that's the foundation, first of all. Now, the three things that will destroy your marriage are these. One, and I'm gonna say, let me take a deep breath here. I think all three are equally important, but I'm gonna start with one that I think is probably very challenging, and I'm gonna say it's very challenging based on personal experience. But I happen to be listening to influencers on YouTube and on social media talking about relationships, marriage, you know, men of God, people with godly perspectives on this. And to be honest, I was surprised. Maybe about over 70% of marriages do not have consistent orgasms. In other words, the woman is not satisfied most of the time, more than 70% of the time. So the people who have regular who experience regular pleasure with the physical relationships are in the minority. Can you believe that? Very much in the minority. And there are women who would go through years and years and years of marriage without ever experiencing orgasmic pleasure. And to me, that's not good. That is something that has to be fixed. And even though it is felt or it is said that traditionally it's the man who is more interested in sex and the sexual pleasures, and no, it is not so. The woman might not be as fussy about it, but over time it builds up. And if she's not satisfied for years and years and years, it's eating away at that, the foundation of the marriage. So do not ignore that. If make sure your wife is enjoying the physical relationship, and if it's not happening, seek help, get counseling, and fix that problem. That is number one. Number two is communication. There are many barriers to communication. Communication becomes difficult, especially where you're having some kind of a conflict and resolving a differences in opinions or in a difference in views. I am gonna be honest with you, something I have been guilty of growing up or as going through life as a younger person, and even to this day, I am a conflict avoider, and I don't like conflict. I get nervous and afraid. I don't want to ruffle anybody's feathers. I don't want the man to be upset with me, and if I see that he's getting a little agitated, then I pull back. All right. Now, I think if you are a man and you have a woman like that, you've got to work on encouraging her. You've got to make it easy for her to communicate with you. I met a great guy, and one of the big things, the pluses about him, was that he said to me, please, I want you to just be open and honest. And he really made it easy for me to do so. All right. He's very gentle. He wants to talk, and he doesn't get upset if my view seems very different from his. He will work with that. Guys, please communicate with your partner. And I know some women are difficult to handle, and again, I would say if you're having difficulty with communication, get help. Don't feel that you have to do this on your own. And again, I know this is difficult, because I'm finding that in dealing with a lot of your people these days, they feel that they know everything and they don't want to talk. And I believe it's worth it. It's worth it. And especially if you have children, it's important and it's worth it to keep your marriage. if there's no physical, you know, mental, physical, emotional abuse involved, no abuse involved, you want to keep that marriage. And if the foundation is shaky, work on building it back. Communicate. And the third thing that causes problems in a marriage has to do with money and financial matters, money and financial issues. Now that to me is a big one. Again, if you are the type of man, as the one I described earlier, that has the right foundation, where you have it correct in terms of your investment in this woman, and to me, I see it as a partnership where both are invested in each other. You know, we're not in an age now where the woman just sits at home and does nothing. Both of you are supposed to work together to build something together. That's how I see it, and that is the way I think it works best. Even if you go in the Bible, you see the woman in Proverbs 31, and I'm not preaching here, but she was a merchant. She goes out and she buys fields. She sells things. So it's not just the man going out and working hard and not getting any, you know, and then coming and pouring everything into the woman. So you need to work out financial matters, and when there are issues or problems or concerns, you work them out together. I still believe that the best situation is where the man is able to lead his woman, and the woman is not struggling against him. You guys are a team, building a legacy together, taking care of your family. So take care of the intimacy, the physical relationship, your communication, and also be supportive in your finances. It's where the woman is also trying to build with you, but you're also building outside with others. You're gonna lose her if you do that. And really continue to value her. The approach you took when you found her, like that treasure in the field, continue to treasure her and see her for who she really is, a gem. Scriptures also say, he who finds a wife finds a good thing. The woman is your good thing. Honor her, respect her, take care of her. I was listening to another social media influencer, RC Blakes, and he said something that was, I found, very instructive, very interesting, and very true. And he was sharing about his own experience where, before marriage, the relationship ended for a period of time and came back together in the end, thank goodness. But he said something that will stick with me for good. He said, he gave the illustration of, let's say you go to New York and you're at the Empire State Building. When you're standing at the door of the Empire State Building, you do not see the entire building. However, as you step away and the building becomes more distant, that's when you see the entire building. And I was like, wow, that's a good one. Because sometimes when you're too close in a relationship, you know, they say familiarity breeds contempt. I mean, that particular quote is not necessarily what I'm trying to say, but sometimes when you get too close to a situation, you take it for granted and you don't see the real value that you have in this person until you lose it and the person is distant. And sometimes this is what happens too with men who may come across good women. You become too close to the woman from a distance. You say, wow, this is a polished gem. Oh my goodness, I have something good here. But something happens as you get closer, then you start looking at her someplace that, because that one is now distant, you're looking at something that isn't even good or good for you. You're becoming attracted to that because it's in a distance. Now, what my challenge is, do not allow this to happen to you. Appreciate what you have. Step away sometimes and value. See the value of what you have found in this woman, and be a keeper. Keep her. Be supportive. Many women will leave when they do not feel supported. They do not feel supported. Women are naturally caregivers. You know, they'll take care of you, they'll feed you, they'll take care of the home, take care of the children. But if you as a man do not support her and hold her hands as she's also holding your hands up, she's going to leave. The marriage is gonna break down, and eventually you're gonna lose this woman. So be supportive. The woman is your good thing. Honor her, respect her, take care of her, and I wish you all the best. Good luck. Again, this is Angie Marie. I want to thank you for spending this time with me. Good luck, all the best in your relationship. I pray that if you're having challenges in a marriage right now, or probably trying to find the right partner, I wish you all the best with it. And as I said earlier too, there's help out there that you can get. Do not be afraid to seek counsel and to seek help, because it is worth it. See you soon in the next video.